down this way. We were passed by dozens of first responders. I'm going to step out of the way so you can get a better idea of the scene here. There are so many first responders down here. All you can see is those flashing lights. Again, this is South Austin near the Brody and Slaughter Lane intersection. And Austin Travis County EMS is reporting that at least one person has been injured. This is the fifth explosion to take place in Austin, if this is reported to be linked to that serial bomber. It's the sixth, including the Schertz explosion this morning. The first explosion was back on March 2nd, then there were two more March 12th. Those were all in East Austin. There was one Sunday night that was in Southwest Austin, and then one this morning at that Schertz FedEx distribution center. And now we're here in South Austin again looking at this scene, this breaking news scene, where there are just so many authorities. We've seen the federal authorities, the local authorities, and everybody rushed to this scene. And it's just horrifying to think that this is happening yet again here in Austin. Mike and Rebecca.
Okay.
Helicopters, I heard lights all at once.
I'm sorry, guys, but you have to move all the way back to the traffic signal light, okay? Because they're setting up a command post right here in this area.
Yeah, they're moving us all the way back. intersection of Brody Lane and Slaughter. There are dozens of authorities here. In fact, many of them passed us while we were on our way here. We had to pull over several times just to let them through. We've seen the federal authorities. We've seen local authorities. DPS is here. Of course, APD is here. And they've had to push us back several times because they are working to set up a command center. Now, if this is a confirmed explosion, or once it is a confirmed explosion, this would be the fifth explosion to take place in Austin. The first back on March 2nd, and that was in Northeast Austin. Then there were two more on March 12th, that was in East Austin. And then on Sunday night, there was an explosion in Southwest Austin. And then again this morning, there was an explosion at a FedEx processing center that was in Schertz, Texas, that was not in Austin city limits. However, there have been reports that that package did originate here in Austin and was sent to that Schertz processing center. So right now we have dozens of authorities. I'm going to step out of the way and see what you can see here. Like I said, we have been pushed back quite a ways so that they could set up a command center here. There are still a lot of media who have not moved back, but they are being told to move back. So one by one, they're doing so. And you can see all those flashing lights. I mean, we're still hearing sirens coming through here. There are still authorities showing up on scene here. And we're back at the intersection of Silk Oak and Brody Lane. So we are pushed back quite a ways from Slaughter Lane. Mike and Rebecca. Let me see if my photographer can zoom in on the left down here is that Goodwill store. Sorry, the ATF just showed up, so it might be a second before we can get a shot of this. We do have a lot of federal authorities still coming in here, still trying to set up these command posts, but we'll try to get you a shot of this Goodwill store right now if we can. It's the same thing we've been hearing with all of these other explosions. Witnesses are still telling us that it's that deep boom is the noise that they're describing, kind of like a bass or something like a transformer blowing, but a little bit deeper than that. And we haven't heard for sure if that witness saw anything, but we could actually smell smoke as we were pulling into this area. We're not 100% sure if that's from that explosion, but it was definitely a very strong smell, almost kind of smelled like sulfur. And we do know ATC EMS has said there is one reported injury here. One person has been injured, so we're not quite sure how bad those injuries are. Communication we've had from officers thus far is really just them telling us that we needed to move back. We were a lot closer a little bit earlier, and they said that they needed to set up a command post where we were standing, so they did push us back to this intersection here at Silk Oak and Brody Lane. So we are a couple blocks away now from Slaughter Lane, where this explosion has been reported. around Austin when we interviewed them. Like you were saying, there are hundreds of federal authorities here in Austin. We have heard people saying they've never seen this kind of response. This is an unprecedented response here in Austin. And there are just so many federal authorities, so many officers here, just trying to make sure that everybody's safe and also hoping that they're going to be able to catch this suspect sooner than later so nobody else gets injured. Mike and Rebecca? Mike, Rebecca, like you were just saying, police are saying that they do not think that this was a bomb. They think it was an incendiary device that maybe went off and caused those injuries. But again, people here are traumatized all over Austin right now because there have been the explosions going off. And so we're seeing this unprecedented kind of response every time there is a report of an explosion, no matter where that is in the city.